Earlier this week, I submitted a sample for the COVID-19 test. The result came in this evening, and I regret to say that it is positive. According to the protocols for managing COVID-19, I'm in self-isolation as required by the case management guidelines issued by the Nigerian Center for Disease Control. That is for someone that is showing no symptoms. I wish to appeal to the people of Kaduna State to continue to closely observe the preventive measures already announced by our government. It is most important that everyone should do their utmost to stay safe, stay home, and stay alive. The Deputy Governor is in charge of our task force on COVID-19. I will continue to issue statements from time to time. Thank you very much. The good people of Kaduna State. In the evening of Saturday, 28th March 2020, I was notified that I had been tested positive for COVID-19 or coronavirus. I immediately made a public disclosure of this sad news and proceeded into isolation under the strict supervision of our medical professionals. I'm delighted to report today that after nearly 4 weeks of observing a strict medical regime, I have now received the all clear after 2 consecutive negative test results. I thank Almighty Allah for His grace and mercy. I also acknowledge with gratitude the massive outpouring of sympathy, prayers, and public support that followed the disclosure of my infection. My family not only went through the trauma of potentially losing a member, but also the risk of being infected as well. The entire family has been supportive as usual, while my many friends and colleagues from across Nigeria and all over the world have sent their prayers and best wishes, and I thank them. I wish to also thank the diligent medical personnel of our State Ministry of Health and the Barodiko Teaching Hospital, who manage my case, for their dedicated and professional care. It was cheering to see the determined efforts of our State COVID-19 Task Force, chaired by the Deputy Governor. The officials of the Ministry of Health, ably led by the Commissioner, and our security and enforcement agencies, who collaborated and worked together to manage and contain the spread of COVID-19 in our state. I wish to acknowledge our Deputy Governor, Dr. Hadiza Sabwab Al-Arabi, for her reassuring leadership of our team in my absence. In this trying period, our senior officials have demonstrated admirable commitment and flexibility to provide governance in circumstances that are so different from the old normal. The commitment, competence, and capabilities displayed by the Kaduna State Government in my 4-week absence is clear evidence that we now have a public service that we can all be proud of. I'm relieved by my recovery. With the privilege of life, sound health, and the support and prayers of our citizens, I will continue to lead the efforts of the Kaduna State Government to ensure that as few of our people as possible get infected by COVID-19, and that those who do get infected can receive adequate and timely care and treatment. Our emphasis is rightly on prevention, because it is the prudent thing to do to save lives given the limited capacity of our health system. I'm delighted by the recovery of 4 other COVID-19 cases who were discharged last week, which was followed yesterday with the discharge of a 5th patient. On Monday, we received the sad news that 3 more positive cases have been discovered in Kaduna. They will receive the best care that our dedicated health professionals can muster, and we wish them speedy recovery from COVID-19. We must all work hard to ensure that we keep coronavirus or COVID-19 out of Kaduna State. We have lower infection rates than expected due to the stringent measures we imposed very early in our state. But we cannot let our guards down. We live in dangerous times. This disease is a threat to our humanity, our lives, and our livelihoods. As someone that has experienced it, I will not wish it on my worst enemy. We must reiterate that an infected person can show no symptoms, as I did, for up to 2 weeks, while unknowingly infecting others close to him or even through casual contact. That is why mixing with many people is not a good idea anymore. While 4 out of every 5 infected persons show mild symptoms like headache, fever, and cough and recover fully, there is evidence worldwide that older people and those with pre-existing health challenges like hypertension and diabetes are particularly at greater risk of dying if they get the COVID-19 infection. We must therefore do everything to avoid exposure and prevent the spread of this disease in our towns and villages. We must now make the sacrifices of enhanced domestic hygiene, regular hand washing with soap, staying at home, and avoiding crowds to defeat this deadly disease. Let me conclude by informing the citizens of Kaduna State that I have issued a further amendment to the quarantine regulations requiring everyone in the state henceforth to wear a face mask when going out of the home or workplace for any reason. The state government is going to make these masks available free to the poor and vulnerable groups and if possible to each and every citizen of the state. I encourage everyone that can afford it to get their neighborhood tailors to sew cloth masks for their use. This will help protect them, their loved ones, and everyone else from the spread of this disease. Once again, we appeal to everyone to stay at home, observe social distancing, avoid gatherings of more than 10 people, and wash our hands with soap and water regularly. Stay home, stay safe, save lives. God bless and protect Kaduna State. God bless and protect the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Thank you.